A text message. That's how the Victorian Health Minister let Premier Daniel Andrews know she was quitting. Jenny Mikakos resigned this morning after an explosive day at the state's hotel quarantine inquiry. Despite her sudden departure, she insists her actions didn't push Victoria into lockdown.
Premier insists she wasn't pushed, but in the end, Jenny Mikakos jumped before that could happen, only telling Daniel Andrews via text.
I believe that Jenny's made the right choice. But she made that choice.
The Premier told the hotel quarantine inquiry yesterday the Health Minister was ultimately responsible for the program. Less than 24 hours later, Ms Mikakos was gone as Minister and from Parliament. In a scathing letter, she said, in light of the Premier's statement to the Board of Inquiry and the fact that there are elements in it that I strongly disagree with, I believe that I cannot continue to serve in his cabinet. I am disappointed that my integrity has sought to be undermined.
She's the one that's asserting that. You'd need to speak to her about that.
Ms Mikakos told the inquiry she didn't know security guards were being used until late May.
I would have had no reason to turn my mind to issues around security guards until we have that first case.
But nearly 2 months earlier, she stood next to Minister Martin Pakula at a media conference when he'd confirmed they'd be part of the program.
At those Melbourne hotels with security guards in place.
There have been a chorus of calls for her to resign, including from the Health Workers Union, who've welcomed today's news.
I'll leave that to Victoria. I honestly don't have any observations on those things.
The reaction in her electorate was divided.
She might have got thrown under the bus a bit. She's taken the accountability.
I wouldn't know what to do in her position, to be honest, so I guess she did what she could.
The Premier says he won't be following her lead.
I don't run from problems and challenges. I've got a very important job to do.
As damaging as the resignation looks for the Andrews government, it likely won't affect its numbers in Parliament. Ms Mikakos sat in the upper house, so there'll be no need for a by-election. Labor will be able to choose her replacement.
Ms Mikakos departs after two decades in Parliament. She'll be replaced as Health Minister by current Minister for Mental Health, Martin Foley. It's a job not many would envy, with plenty of fallout still to come over the state's pandemic response.
And Simon Love joins us now from Melbourne's Treasury Place. Simon, Martin Foley has a big job on his hands.
He certainly has, Chris, and he'll be getting straight down to work with a series of Zoom meetings tonight ahead of a big announcement tomorrow by the government around its roadmap out of restrictions. Now, Martin Foley, he is being sworn in as a Minister for Health in a virtual conference between himself, the Premier, and the Governor of Victoria, Linda Dessau. Now, this entire palaver today is just adding to the embarrassment of the Andrews government over the past two terms. In this term of government, the Andrews government has lost four ministers out of the cabinet and out of the ministry. Over the two terms, it's seven. So no doubt today, in the midst of a pandemic, this is not a position that the Premier wanted to be in, but ultimately he needed this sort of a process to occur and for Minister Mikakos to resign on her own bat to ensure that the state gets on with the pandemic response.
Thanks, Simon. Simon Love there, live from Melbourne.